It's you. I miss you, babe. I want you near me. I want to hug you.
I'm fucking back. Told you I'd be back.
I actually had to lie in the title to make it a little bit more enticing. I'm actually going to be talking about mostly my favorites from last year. So welcome to Clickbait Central, baby. Next week, I'm going to be filming a room decorating video. So subscribe if you're into that idea, or subscribe if you're into me. I'm going to start this video with music recommendations, and 80% of these are not going to be recommendations, they're going to be reminders. You know a lot of these people, some of them you might not know. If you want a little foreshadowing into my music taste, all five of my Spotify Wrapped top genres last year were just some variation of pop, so I do think I have the most incredible range. I listened to Emails I Can't Send a mentally ill amount of times last year. Three of the top songs on my top songs were from this album. If you want to be even more concerned about my listening habits, I listened to Vicious 247 times. Oh, you're so vicious, love me. That's not even over the whole year. Like, the album was released in July, I'm pretty sure. I've listened to it literally almost 250 times in 6 months. Preparation to seeing Kehlani, literally probably the day this video goes up, I have been listening to Blue Water Road. Fucking amazing album. I'm kind of sad I didn't listen to it before, but I'm excited to see it in concert. Here are my favorites. There's this like really underground album you might not have heard of. It's called SOS by SZA. I don't have an original bone in my body. Here are my top five, honestly. You push me past my own capacity. Those are the albums. Here are three artists I think you should know about that are a little bit more underrated. My name is Hi. You got my attention. Can't come to a sense of it. I would go to get to the Henny and the Hamptons. Hey, I don't wanna wake up from it. You've given me a place and time. Participated in a few little fashion trends here and there this year, but I want to tell you about the ones that I would actually kill a man to participate in. I love leg warmers. I don't know if I'd style them in the way that people like them, but I don't care. I love the trend of knitwear this year. I've got this one, which is one of my favorites, and I have this one, which is another one of my favorites. Big pants. These ones like engulf my ankles. I really like people who put ribbon in their hair. I think that's adorable. I'm actually filming this video in reverse order, so I'm actually getting really sick of filming, and I'm just gonna kind of race through these trends that I would love to participate in. The first one is fur. Even though I'm like fundamentally kind of against fur, I really enjoy faux fur. And I like earmuffs, I like jackets, I like boots. I really like patterned tops, like kind of the ones that kind of give you an illusion that you're like a young mom, you know what I mean? And as I said, I really like patterned sweaters. I like the crochet is coming back. I like the knitting is coming back. I think they make really cute items in your wardrobe. I like the stars are coming back into style. I don't know what it is. I even have earrings. Those are flowers. I like that it's on a lot of 90s wear. I think it's really cute. The last two trends I really like are like mini skirts, like the ones that you like realistically aren't very functionable but are very mini. I think they're really cute and I really like people who are brave enough to wear them. And the last thing I really like is Afghan coats. I think they're really cute and I would love to own 5 or 7. I am the worst personal life. I have this conversation with pretty much everyone I meet, but I don't really watch media, and you can put your favorite show or movie in the comments. I most likely haven't seen it. You can put the most popular movie or TV show in the comments. I probably haven't seen it. Here are a few things I would recommend, even as a picky media watcher. I'd highly recommend the Fair Street trilogy if you are into slashes and horror movies. They're fucking amazing. I actually prefer them in reverse order. Euphoria season 2 was really good. I actually rewatched it because I didn't have as much appreciation as I wanted the first time around, and I actually really liked it the second time around, so. I watched Avatar 2, and I know there's a lot of controversy, but I actually stayed awake for 3 whole hours, and to me that means something. I liked Wednesday. I think it could have been a little less juvenile, but I also really, really enjoyed it. I watched Skins for the first time, and I'm glad I watched it for the first time at 21 years of age, rather than like 14 years of age. Or I would have been permanently impaired. I watched a show called The Patient, and it's got Steve Carell in it, and you actually probably don't know about the show, so I'm excited to recommend it. It's a psychological thriller. It's really good. It's also got the guy from About Time in it, and it's just amazing. They drop episode by episode every week, so it was a lot more stressful for me, but if you binge it all in one go, I think it'll be a little less intense. But yeah, I'd highly recommend it if you're interested in that shit. The level of like euphoria I felt when Greta Thunberg ratioed Andrew Tate and then further got him arrested was indescribable, even for me, so I have no idea how she felt. I loved Euphoria season 2. The first 2 episodes, my sister and I watched it on a live stream, so it was so laggy, but like it's part of the fun, and you know, you couldn't really be on Twitter unless you've like watched the episode, or you instantly get it spoiled. I miss all the discourse. I miss everything about it. I didn't really care about the Don't Worry Darling premiere drama, but I think the part where people thought Harry spit on Chris Pine was so funny. Me personally, I saw the spit only the first time I watched the video. I've actually seen the movie, and it was probably up there with one of the worst movies I've ever seen, and it's definitely the worst ending I've ever seen in a movie. I literally cried laughing. It made no sense at all. I had no clue who the Try Guys were before mid this year, and I'm so glad I know who they are now. I think the cheating drama was obviously a traumatic time for everyone involved, but what a moment, what a time in my life. I don't know if Wordle was popularized in 2022. I'm pretty sure it was end of 2021, but I love Wordle so much, and I love the Twitter hype around it. And I am kind of convinced that it'll slow down any chances of my dementia if I just do Wordle every morning. I love that when SOS came out, everyone was trying to find Big Boy and very quickly found out that it was an SNL skit. I thought that was really funny, and I too hope that it's going to become a song, but I honestly think it would be okay left as an SNL skit as well. I'm sorry. Love Island UK was one of the best months of my life. I only follow Ekansu, I'm pretty sure. She was the highlight for me, but there was also a whole lot of shit that I don't think any other Love Island season is going to compare.
I like sucked her tits or whatever.
How what?
Like licked her tit or whatever. And
I wasn't impressed with last year's Met Gala, but I did have a fucking good time rating everything. It is my personal Super Bowl. I want to show you a few items that I've bought. Kind of a little bit hindered my ability to pay rent, but I think it's still just as necessary.
The first thing I really needed was this light. You smack it, turns on. Kind of has that new vacuum smell.
I bought it because I'm an interesting fella. Next thing I bought was a cheeky monkey. Don't worry about the whole wild animal thing. He's domesticated. Don't call Peter. They already know the situation. And his name's Lockie. It's not really like named after anyone in particular. I just thought it was a nice name. The next thing I bought was a facial spray. I really don't know the purpose of these, but they feel so good and they smell so good. So that is plenty of reason for me. It's puffin' season, all
the girls be needin'. Knickknack. 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 I really love buying prints. I have a huge amount of wall space in my new flat, so I'm gonna have to fill it with prints. I have this one, which is basically a friggin' margarita pizza. Ah! It's just a recipe for it.
I think it's really cute. Very last thing I bought is a student planner. I don't know why I shut that in your face, but I really, really need one of these. I'm not happy with my grades. Hopefully this will help me be happy with my grades. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stick around for next week. I will be uploading next week as well. That sounds so crazy. My life is so crazy. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you enjoy me. Bye.